It's a wonderful day again today. Welcome everybody for this wonderful presentation. My name is Gabriel Aura, and it's a presentation from Aspire Software Limited. So today I want to take you through a topic of how do I choose the right system. That one has been a question that has been asked by so many businessmen, and due to public interest, I've chosen just to prepare this discussion today so that I can lead you through questions that can make you make the right decision when you're looking for a system, especially for your business. Now, the topic is how do I choose the right system, or how do I choose the right software for my business? Now, you can see in the picture there, and I'm sure most of us could be like that at times. You know, we wonder so much of what we need to do. Maybe a lot of things you have no idea, and you also have many questions that you could be asking yourself. So it is understandable. Most people, in one way or the other, have been through that situation. But today, believe you me, once we are through this, then I'm sure you will have actually a direction to know the kind of a system that you may need for your business. Now, the question is, do I actually choose a better system? Now, one of the questions perhaps you could ask yourself is that, do I need a better software? I know currently you could be using another software in your business, and then maybe you realize that it has some shortcomings, and maybe at times you'll be like, how can I improve this? So if you're looking for a system, you have to maybe have the idea of like, are you looking for a better system? Or maybe you are in need of a system, or maybe you don't have a system in your retail shop or in your business, and you're looking for a system that can help you do things. Or maybe you have a system, but you need a better one. So these are the questions that we'll need to ask ourselves. Now, the question number two you'll ask yourself is, how do I wish to manage my company and its growth? Definitely, most of us will not want to be stagnant. We will want our companies to grow. And then you have that, a vision of its growth. You may have one branch today, tomorrow you may have 100 branches. How will you wish to manage those growth? So definitely, at some point, you will need actually a system. Now, the third question you'll ask yourself is that, does the software only do the system you're looking for, or the software you're looking for? Do you want it to do specific tasks, or you want it to do for you everything in your business? Okay? There are people who will want a software just because they just want to sell. Others, they will need a software simply because they just want to procure things and know how much they are receiving. And then others will only need a software just to handle their financial management or their accounting packages only. So these are some of the things you need to ask yourself. If you're looking for this software, are you looking only for a POS or for an accounting, or for maybe, let's say, only HR? Or you are looking for a software or a system that can be able to do for you everything in your business? Now, the other question is, can the software also grow with my business? Today you may have one branch. Tomorrow you may have, just like I said, 100 branches tomorrow. Now, will you be able to grow with the software? Because from our experiences, we've come to realize that there are some softwares which are not scalable enough. They cannot handle up to a certain number of stock. So when it reaches there, stock now in Anzakuame, it becomes messed up. So you find most of the time you are selling on negative, or even you may be selling products that you are not even aware if they're in your premise, because the software cannot track that. So these are some of the things that you need to ask yourself. Can the software also grow with your business? Now, the other thing is that, do you look at only for a POS or a point of sale, or you also need an accounting, just like the way we said earlier, that you need a software that can do everything, or you are looking for a specific software? Now, the other question is, you can ask yourself, is that, can it handle also human resource, payroll processing, time and attendance, that is the T and A here, time and attendance. Do you need a software that can handle all this? Now, most of the HR softwares that these software vendors will send you or they will sell to you, some of them, they will only sell you specific functions. Somebody will tell you, I'm giving you an HR system, but it is only for time and attendance. It doesn't have payroll processing. Or maybe they will sell you as an HR software that only handles payroll processing, but it does not actually handle time and attendance. So some of the things you'll find, you'll have to look for Excel sheet to do that. So are you looking for a system that can only handle, if it is HR, that can only handle payroll, or you're looking for a system that can only handle time and attendance, or you're looking for a system that can handle both? So these are the questions that you need to ask yourself. What about multi-branch? Today you have one branch. Tomorrow you'll have two, three branches. Like we said, 100 branches. The system you're using today, will it be able to handle those multi-branch operations? So multi-branch operations. So that is what you also need to think about when you're looking for this system. If it is capable of handling multi-branch operations as a fact of accommodating your growth, then that is okay. That is very, very okay. And then the other issue here is, can it control pilferage? This is now where most businesses have challenges a lot, because there is a lot of pilferage or theft, especially when the stock is on transit. How do you actually monitor that stock that is on transit? And secondly, stock control at all levels. How can you be able to control stock at all levels? At times, branches, they will order stock that they do not need. How do you put a branch limit of a certain amount of stock or a certain amount of value stock? Okay. And then issues to do with electronic article surveillance support. Does the system also be able to support that? Because if they realize that system is not supporting such things like these ones, you find there's a lot of pilferage or a lot of theft that will be happening in your shops. So these are some of the things that when you're looking for a system, you should focus on to know how you can control your stock on transit, your stock control at all levels, and even be able to support electronic article surveillance support. Now, the other thing is that, can it handle centralized gift vouchers? Okay. Now, it is quite shocking, especially at this age and time, you find that a gift voucher is issued by the same company, but it cannot be used in a different branch of the same company. So if I issued that gift voucher, let's say I issued it in Westlands, only Westlands branch, then it means customers from Westlands are only supposed to use those gift vouchers in Westlands. So if they go, like in Karen, or they go, maybe let's say in Eastlands, they will not be able to use that gift voucher. So that will be very useless. So you need a system that can handle things in a central manner, so that if I issue a gift voucher in Nairobi, a customer will be able to use it even if she or he travels to Eldoret, Kakamega, or Kisumu. They are at the comfort of using this gift vouchers because it is issued by the same company. Now, the other thing is that, what of loyalty? Now, this is a major thing, because especially for the retailers, if you are doing supermarket or you are doing wholesale, you must introduce a loyalty system there, because most customers will want to be valued. They will want to know exactly how are we being recognized in this business of this person. And mostly with Kenyans, they like that. They like incentives and all that. So this is another tool to ensure that your business has a lot of traffic in terms of loyalty programs, so that mentally your customers are rested to you. You arrest them mentally so that you can maintain them in your premise. So this is what the system is supposed to do for you. And then all seamlessly with accounting, because there is no business that works without accounting. Every system needs to actually support accounting norms. So any system that you purchase, ensure that with accounting functionality are actually to the core, and they are deemed according to the accounting norms and functionality and rules and regulations of accounting. So every system must adhere to the accounting operations. And then what of multi-currency? Okay, you may have suppliers especially who are international suppliers, and most of the time, as I see, Kenyans, a lot of SMEs in Kenya, they do a lot of business with the Chinese suppliers. So you will need a system that you are able also, when you do payment, you are able to do payment with the different currencies, and mostly, of course, in dollars if you're talking of international suppliers. Likewise, also, you may have even customers who are not only from Kenya or Tanzania. You may have customers all over Africa or internationally. So you need a system that can be able to help you transact on a multi-currency level. So because the world is changing, the world is becoming a village, and as you are doing business, even if it is an SME, that is what you need to think about. You need to think global, and the system you get it should be a system that gives you global. And then there is also touchscreen capability. This is a new technology. Yeah, a lot of point of sales are actually embracing new technology of the touchscreen. A lot of things are going on touchscreen. Now, the system you are using, will it be able actually to support touchscreen capability? Okay. Now, the advantages of using touchscreen, especially on POSs, because one thing, the machines themselves, they look very presentable, which is one of the marketing tools. They look very presentable. Now, secondly, it is actually efficient in terms of service. With a touch screen, it is more faster. Okay? It is more faster because the cashiers are just direct. And then secondly, you avoid a lot of cables around which may cause unnecessary accidents within your premise. So you find that is one of the best ways and biggest merits of using touch screen capability than just this other normal machines. Yeah, and I'm also told with my colleague here that even they are cost effective. They are cost effective. You know, they are cheaper as in terms of buying a normal CPU. You buy a normal CPU, you must get a CPU and a monitor, you know, and then get mouse and keyboards and all that stuff. But you see, with touchscreen, you get just all in one. It's inbuilt. So it's very efficient and very cost effective. So you also need to get a system that can support weighing scale integrated, and then label and barcode printing, okay? And I'm sure most of the system that I've come across, some of them actually they do support this. You find one of the systems supports labels and barcode printing, and then maybe they may not have weighing scale integrated, or you'll find some of them may have weighing scale integrated, but they are actually not capable of printing labels and barcode printing. So in any business, that is a must. That is very essential. In any business, especially, we are talking in terms of retail, supermarkets, and distribution wholesale. This is very essential when you're looking for a system that can assist you do your operations without any hassle. Now, the other question is the system digital? Are you able to manage documents digitally, okay? So that you limit a lot of papers in the office, okay? Because with the technology, the way it's moving is that there is less and less and less papers that are going to be used. So for you to also be able to limit the cost of purchasing papers and the cost of storing papers in your office in terms of buying files and all that, you can easily just scan the document, and after scanning the document, you upload it into your system, and then it becomes a digital document whereby anybody within the company, both remotely and locally, can be able to access that document without any hassle. It saves you also the hassle of maybe you realize that an invoice or a supplier invoice has been misplaced. That one happens a lot in a lot of businesses. Okay? You find that you're looking for this supplier because you have issues with him, and then you want to prove if at all he really distributed goods. Then you are looking for that invoice badly, then you find somebody misplaced it. Okay? And then when you try to look for that person, oh, maybe unfortunately the person has gone to leave. He's on leave. So until you wait when he comes back, that is when now he will show you, or she will show you where the document was stored. So you avoid unnecessary inconveniences by actually saving these documents digitally. That is the way to go, guys. That is the way to go. And of course, in Kenya, M-Pesa, Airtel Money and debit cards. In Kenya, M-Pesa is big time. So if you don't have M-Pesa in Kenya, or your system does not support M-Pesa, oh man, I think you will be, this is actually, you know, it is very, very essential, because most Kenyans right now, they are supporting M-Pesa. They transact a lot of things in the M-Pesa. And even at times, if they don't have money, they can buy things through Fuliza. And Fuliza is simply M-Pesa. So if your system does not support M-Pesa, it means you are losing a lot, because we have over 60% of the customers in Kenya operating M-Pesa. So make sure you don't lose these customers. Okay? Make sure you don't lose them. Ensure you get a system that can support that. And then we have Airtel Money, vending at the POS. Now, this is where, guys, I wanted us to concentrate on this. I know most of the businesses nowadays, what they do is that they sell hard cash, those cards, in terms of airtime. Okay? They sell airtime. You know, you for wholesalers or distributors, you will give a salesperson a number of value, stock value of airtime, and then you tell him, go sell it. And then in the evening, you come back and show me what you've sold and the balance, and that from there, you cancel everything. Now, that is very dangerous. One, because these guys now, they've actually, the people you call them, your salespersons, they've actually developed a mechanism. Some of them, instead of selling your own stock, they may choose to have their own stock. They go within the field, use your customer, and then they sell those stocks to their customers, to your own customers. And then when they come back to you, they return to you your stock, telling you that, hata leo customers hawakuwa wengi. But in actual sense, they are selling their own stock within your own premise, which is a very big disadvantage, you see? Which is a very big disadvantage. So what you need to do, getting a system that can support airtime vending, whereby, like, you go to Safaricom, you purchase airtime in bulk, then Safaricom just pushes it to your server. So if somebody wants a credit worth 50 shillings or 100 bob, they can simply just go directly to your point of sale and purchase that airtime worth of 100 shillings or 50 shillings, depending with the amount that they want. And then the POS just prints a receipt. That receipt is an airtime. So they get it and fill their phones and go. Instead of having bulk stock of airtime in your premise, whereby the guys you're entrusting, they will not sell it. They will simply come with their own airtime stock and sell it to your customers. Yeah? That is a very big loophole, and you need to avoid that. So look for a system that can support this airtime vending, because this is the way to go, and this is where technology and businesses are moving. Now, the other thing is that, is the POS you're looking for, or the system you're looking for, is it fast enough or is it slow? Okay, in terms of checkout, okay, it is always a very bad impression when a customer has selected things at the shelf, and then when he wants to pay or she wants to pay, she goes to your POS and finds that the cashier or the system is actually slow. Okay, he finds the system is slow. That is very discouraging, and you'll find like there's some customers end up even leaving the baskets there, because they can't even catch up with time, because your checkout is not efficient enough. So look for a system that is fast enough, and it avoids actually you losing customers at the point of sale. And then find for a system, can you run your system from anywhere? That system you're looking for, can you run it from anywhere? From your iPad or your Android, can it run from anywhere? Yeah, you look for a system that can support that. And then what if there is a change in the law? Yeah, the vendor easily support the changes. Like, most of the time I've seen people purchasing a lot of Microsoft systems. Okay, a lot of people support Microsoft system. And what they do is that once they've bought the Microsoft system, what happens if tomorrow, in the law, let's say in Kenya, if the government changes the law, you find that Microsoft will not be able to actually adjust their system to, you know, suit the laws of the land. because it's a big company and they have quite a big niche of customers worldwide. So why will they customize the system just for you, or even just because of your government or something like that? It is very difficult, and in fact, for you to reach them and convince them, it will have taken a lot of time. So look for vendors, and that's why we normally advise you look for vendors who are locally. Like if they are Kenyan developers, find Kenyan developers who are very good. Okay? They can be able to give you a system that in case if there are changes tomorrow, they will be there to help you and change everything so that they can upgrade your system easily. So these are some of the things that you need to focus on. Now, are the developers from abroad? How quick are changes? Do they understand my business? That is in terms of Microsoft, as we have discussed. Then how stable is the product? Always calling for support or focusing on my business. There are some of the systems that are going to be like that. You purchase them, you find that every now and then there are runtime errors, the system has hung. So you are constantly concentrating on that system other than concentrating on the growth of your business. So such are like systems, actually avoid them like plague. Avoid them like plague, seriously. Do away with them. Can you be able to export documents either in PDF, Excel, Word, or email? Okay, most of the systems actually are supposed to do that. If you want to do an email supportive. If you want to, okay, you can be able to, you know, export a document in whatever format. Not only PDF, Excel, Word, email, you're supposed also to have in terms of CSVs, okay, and all those CSV, XSL, all those kinds of formats, the system is supposed to support that. So can it handle the load or scalable? Is your system scalable enough? Can it handle the load in terms of when you're growing? Will it be able to handle, okay, the your stock capacity, okay? Because when you're growing, your stock also grows and you are increasing the number of stock. So will your system be able to handle that? So those are some of the things that you need to check when you're looking for the system. What of loss of data? What are the plans of backup recovery? Now, this one mostly goes to the vendors of the system, those people who are giving you the system, okay? These are some of the things that they need to advise you. In case of anything, are they capable of actually helping you to recover your data? Let's say, for example, in your shop, people come and they vandalize your server, or maybe, God forbid, yeah, something happens and fire comes at your premise, burns everything. Okay, how will you recover back the data that you're having so that you can know the stock value you are dealing with? Okay, so these are some of the things your vendors are supposed to advise you before they sell you the system. So how is the support in terms of support? Okay, pre and post training, is there a cost? Okay, there are some of the vendors, also companies, who are selling the system. You need also to discuss with them or ask if they install a system to you, for you, are they going to charge you in terms of training, or are they going to charge you after training? Okay, and then if there are any other costs, they need also to know, they need also to let you know if there be any other cost. Also, there are other hidden costs, small hidden costs. Yeah? Some of them are amikoras. Yeah? They will tell you this very nicely and sweetly, talk to you nicely. But after you bought the system, that is when you start realizing there are some other hidden costs here and there. So these are some of the things that you need to clarify with them before you get yourself into their trap. So references of companies using vendor system. There are some people who will send you the system, but they don't have, or there is no customer who has ever used their system. Okay, they don't have any references. So they need to show you the reference of those clients they have, the people that are using their system. And maybe in future, you may go there secretly and just inquire from them to see how the system works. Or at times you don't even inquire, just go into their shops, pretend like you're a customer, look at their checkout at the POS, is the system slow? Things like those ones. Look at their shelf labels. How are they? Are they nicely put, or are they dirty and all that stuff? So these are some of the things that you need to check. You do just your own research to ensure that you know what you are getting. Struggling using Excel sheets. Okay, most of the systems, they will always make you use Excel sheets. Okay, every report that you need to compile, sales, you have to compile a report, an Excel sheet for you to upload it to another system. Okay, are you using multiple systems to control your diverse businesses? Okay, if you are using multiple systems, POS unatumia system A, accounting you are using system B. So in between data here, you have to control, you have to push data from one system to the other using Excel sheets. That is dangerous, very, very dangerous, and it is an avenue of theft. Now, is existing POS or ERP giving you incorrect stocks? Okay, there are some of the systems that give you incorrect stocks. Very, very funny. You've actually straightened stock Leo. Tomorrow you go back, you find stocks in Meruka. Stocks is unauza negative, you're selling on negative. So those are some of the things that you need to actually look on. Wish to streamline operations and reduce staff? Not exactly reducing staff. When you speak of reducing staff, is that not necessarily sacking this staff, but you make this staff useful in some other areas. Okay? Maybe you may be having over 10 accountants. Okay? You may be having over 10 accountants, but with an installation of the right system, you will find that you will only need maybe 5 accountants. So the rest 5, you can deploy them to other areas where they can be useful. Maybe you can make them branch managers, or they can be procurement managers, whereby at the branches, they are just receiving, they will stand there receiving goods from suppliers. Do you love to see daily net profit and expense from all sources on your iPhone or BBI, or not BBI exactly, but your BlackBerry, something like that? Yeah. So are you willing? Most of the directors will want to do that. Most of the directors will want to see that. Okay. You don't have to be hassle. You don't have to hassle. You don't have to be in the business premise for you to be able to see the progress of your business. All you need to do is just open your iPhone or your BlackBerry and check, see what exactly is going on. Okay. Offer essential reports that you are going to receive in respect of the operations of the business. So these are some of the things that the business you are looking for, you need to check on. You need to check on these things and be able to have your business at the palm of your hands. Okay. Now, with all those questions, this is where now we come in as Aspire Software Limited. Okay. Those questions we answer them for you. Okay. And one of the things as Aspire we believe in, we believe that you can dream. And one of the dreams you may have is that you dream to have a good software in your, you need to have a good software. That could be a dream. Then when you share with us that dream, okay, we build that dream for you. Okay, you share with us your dream and then we build the dream for you. And after we've built the dream for you, then you definitely succeed. You smile, just like my brother here is smiling, because we actually helped him succeed. Okay, so that is what Aspire does it for you. Guys, we help you succeed, and we believe if you succeed, then we also, as Aspire team, we succeed. Now, there is also another thing in Aspire that we don't actually allow our clients to work very late. And in this time and age, if you find yourself working very late, then you are actually living an outdated, you are in a different dispensation, so to speak, in a different period of time, because that one has been overrun. Nowadays, people just work smart. You don't need to work so hard. With the correction, with the organization and putting things right with the right system, you just work smart and things work out for you. So avoid working late like this guy I'm seeing here, working very, very, very late. This one, in the year 2020, in the 21st century, that one has been out, gone. Now, iTax stress. There are some of you who may have iTax stress. Your system you're using is not able to support you in terms of iTax. At times, it's very difficult when you think of compiling all the invoice supplier invoices and all that stuff so that your accountant can sit there very late, do all these calculations until maybe he doesn't even sleep, puts his feet on water so that he may be sober overnight. Okay, if the system does not support you in that, know that that system is outdated. You need to upgrade. Okay, it's time for us to upgrade. You need to upgrade. Look for a system that can give you stress-free, especially in terms of iTax. And Aspire Software Limited is here for you. You can send us a question and we will be able to actually fix you. Looking for a manufacturing software? We also have a manufacturing software as Aspire, whereby you are able to monitor your raw materials, know the raw materials and your products, the final products that you are producing, and then monitor the cost of raw material and the cost of the final product. And of course, the cost of production, you're able to check on that. And then at the end of it all, you get the final profitability in terms of percentage and turnover reports. So this is one of the best and wonderful softwares that we have that you may need actually to check on it when you visit our offices someday. Now, do you want to get a perfect trial balance every time with a positive accounting? So these are some of the accounting reports that the positive ERP does it for you automatically. So you end up getting all these wonderful balance sheets, well balanced by the system automatically. No Excel sheets, no human interventions, automatically as your guys are operating. So these are some of the things and which are very good. Now, for example, look at these guys here. If you look at this car, it is overloaded. These are some of the systems we are using today. Yeah, very overloaded and very slow. At times it crashes, just like this car has stopped working. Okay, but if you look at the road is just so nice here. There are no potholes in this road. This road is just perfect. So the man is driving a very, very bad car on a very nice road. Okay, which is incorrigible. Okay, which is incorrigible. And that is what most businesses do. They get very old, outdated system, okay? But they put them in a very good machines, very fast, wonderful machines. And you wonder, if you are able to get all these nice hardwares, couldn't you get a very good software? And that is what is happening most of you, because you think that saving money in your software, it will save you money when you get just a cheap software somewhere. Not forgetting that it is that software that will be running your money in the business. That software, it is the one that is running your millions in that business. It is not the hardware, it is the software. Okay? So if you are, the existing software is letting you down, please make sure you check on us and we will be able to fix things for you. Now, Aspire Software Limited has actually this module, has this software, the Positive ERP. And the Positive ERP is actually designed in modular form. And one of the modules, it is the accounting, which is actually the heartbeat of the entire system. It connects with the other modules. Then the other module is enterprise, which works hand in hand with the accounting. And also through enterprise, you are able to access other remote branches, but you are able to control those remote branches in one central location. And then we have the human resource. This human resource here, it supports time and attendance and payroll processing, both in one. And then also it supports biometrics. So your guys, if your employees, they don't have to write on a book, or maybe a manager doesn't have to compile an Excel sheet, what they only do is that they just come and clock in with their biometrics. And then the system takes over. So an employee may be clocking in Mombasa and the HR is in Nairobi here, but they are able to see real-time information of what is happening in different branches over the attendance of each and every employee. And of course, we have the Smart Manager, which is being used as a data capture for both employees and even for your loyal customers. You are able to use the Smart Manager to run the loyalty system. That is for customers and also for employees. You can capture their data and register their biometrics using the Smart Manager. Okay, so this is we also have the back office. So the back office is a management tool that monitors stocks that are received in the branch and also monitors the performance of those stocks. At the end of it all, you get a very nice report of the sales and the number of customers that were served during that day. And of course, it will generate a Z report, and then you close the day. So all the reports are electronically actually sent to the headquarters all the way back to the accounting. This they are sent back to the accounting electronically. And of course, you'll have, if you need a hard copy, you are able to print those hard copies. I will take you through the tutorials of each and every module so that you are able to see how those modules are really operating. So we also have the front office or the point of sale. It is also the same. The point of sale is used to sell. You sell goods, but at the same time, the POS can be used even to pay off your employees in terms of cash. Yeah, they can take the advances there from the POS. They can clock right from the POS. They can also deposit their money right from the POS. So the POS is designed not necessarily just to sell, but it is designed also to work in harmony with other modules. Yeah, in terms of maybe issuing salaries, in terms of issuing loan, in terms of issuing advances, and in terms of also receiving deposits from your employees. And then we have the StoreX, which is a module that monitors the stores and helps mostly wholesalers, yeah, to control traffic over the counter. So you can put a trigger level at the POS. If somebody buys more than maybe, let's say, 100 bags of cement, then it will trigger the StoreX, so that guy can collect those bags at the store. But if it is below maybe 100 bags, they can still collect it over the counter. So that one helps you to serve those customers who will come to buy in less bulk, and those also who come to buy in bulk format. Either way, they are accommodated in your business. And that is how the positive front office works. So these are actually the basic modules that runs the entire ERP. These are the basic modules that run the entire ERP system. Okay, and the modules are actually interconnected. So one doesn't need, because I know somebody may ask, do I need to have all these modules so that my business can begin? No, you don't need to have all the modules. You can begin anywhere. You can begin, maybe if you have one branch, you can say you can begin with the back office and the front office there, and then you are good to go. Tomorrow you can plug in another module as you grow like that. And then in the future, you may say, now I need an accounting module. Then we plug in the accounting module just like that. So you can begin at a very low one shop, a standalone shop, and then become a multi branches shop, just like the way most of our clients have begun, like the way Katie has begun. They began with a small shop, but now they are multi shops. Okay, now just like the way QuickMart, some years back we found them, they had just a few reasonable shops, some two shops in Nakuru, that is Shirikisho and Shabab. Those were two shops. And then in Nairobi, they only had Ruaka and Ruai. Okay, so in total, they only had four shops when we were beginning with them. But now QuickMart is actually booming. It rocks the entire city now. The rest is history. Okay, so that is the anatomy of the positive ERP. That is the front office, you can see. And you don't have to have everything here, but you can just look at the most important. You can begin with the most important one. Of course, you'll need to have a computer, and then maybe a printer and a scanner. Okay, you can have either this, a fixed scanner, or you can have the handheld scanner. Either way, it can work. It depends with the scalability of your shop. And then, of course, you'll have to, if you need card readers also, you can have card readers. So that is the anatomy of the POS. And the POS supports a lot of hardwares. These are just a few of the hardwares that we've placed here, but it supports a lot of hardwares. Then we have the positive archivage, which is actually a touch screen capability. It also detects weight, it works with weights, and then it also prints its own barcodes. It is fully automated. It can work offline, both online and offline. And then also you are able to view livestock. That stock that are on shelf, you are able to view them there. And then also it updates prices, items, and descriptions centrally. Works seamlessly with the positive front office and back office. At the same time also, it is a front office on its own. It's a POS on its own. It can also sell, just like it is. And It's very easy to use, very, very easy to use, and it interacts with the user. So, and this is also the anatomy of the human resource. You can see this, the anatomy of the human resource. It begins from recruitment all the way down to termination. And then you have the paperclip capability. And I think I had mentioned, I had explained the functionalities of paperclip capability on the other tutorial. So please, you may refer to the other tutorial and check how the paperclip really works and functions. And of course, in every module, there is always a report and analysis of whatever has happened in the course of the day. So we also have the cloud edition. Now, the cloud edition, mostly we don't advise it. Mostly it's never used by serious clients who have a lot of traffic in their premises. Cloud edition, we recommend it to mostly administrative. That is like if there are lawyers, doctors who may need to, you know, check their HR stuff and all that stuff. Those ones, we recommend the cloud edition because of the traffic and all that stuff. And because also with the, you know, the link operations and the internet in this country, it is not dependable. So you may not, we don't want our clients to lose customers just because, you know, lack of internet, they end up losing customers, or they cannot actually serve their customers because internet is not there. So we normally check, and whoever comes with cloud edition, we give you the pros and cons of it because we want you to know what you are getting yourself into. Okay, but it is there. It is a functionality that is there. We've actually given it to a few clients, which it has worked very well. And one of our major clients was Deluxe Fruits. They are the ones who are using the cloud edition now. So you may inquire from them and see how the cloud edition works. Or even you can come to our office, at the Aspire office, and we'll take you through the cloud edition, how it is. Thank you very much. That is the end of my presentation. And thank you very much for your time. And I'm giving you an invitation. Please, if you want to know more, please visit our office, Aspire Software Limited. We are in Spring Valley Business Park, Lower Kabete Road. You are in Block A, first floor. So you come there and ask for Aura, or you ask for Gabriel Aura, and then definitely I'll be there. Or even if you can also call me through this number, 0727-625-340. I repeat, 0727-625-340. Thank you very much. I hope we'll hook up with you guys. You can come so that we discuss and we can give you more advice on what you need to do when you're looking for a software. Otherwise, thank you very much for your time. God bless you.